I'm here with Shibi and his startup Onco Phenomics is for the first time doing liquid biopsy. We all know, you know, the cancer testing is such a dreadful and painful process. We've heard about it, but his company has come out for the first time with liquid biopsy. Through blood test, you can do the diagnosis. Please tell us.
Yeah. So typically, cancer patients go through a surgical biopsy. So typically, there are three types. There's a fine needle biopsy, there's an open surgical biopsy, and then also during the surgery also, when they remove the tissue is sent to the pathology department. So then the pathologist will analyze the tissue and then they give the report. So that's when the diagnosis is made whether this is a real cancer or not. But this is an invasive procedure. It has a lot of risk and it cannot be done in an outpatient. So we recommend a non-invasive procedure, which is the latest trend in oncology, called liquid biopsy.
Wow.
So we are the first in India to do a comprehensive liquid biopsy.
Wow.
Although there are other companies doing it in US and UK and other countries. So our objective is, we are looking at three main objectives. First is make this latest technology accessible to our patients in India. Second is make it affordable. So currently companies like Foundation Medicine and Garden Health, they're charging anywhere from 1.5 lakhs to 5 lakh rupees. And all Aadmi in India cannot afford this kind of testing. So our target pricing is like bring it down all the way to $99, which is like 7,500 rupees. So right now it costs around 25,000 rupees. Once we reach that economies of scale, we can definitely bring it down. Also, we want to get reimbursed by the government schemes like CGHS, Aarogyashree and Ayushman Bharat kind of schemes. And once the insurance companies cover it, the test is practically free.
Yeah.
So this is something we recommend. You have to do it on a regular basis. So ideally, cancer patients goes for three types of treatments, you know, like chemotherapy, radiation or surgery. And now the new treatments have come, the fourth and fifth umbrella. The fourth is the targeted therapies. So where we look at the mutations, like certain genes like EGFR, KRAS and BRAF. If you find these mutations, then the patients can go for a targeted therapies like gefitinib, afatinib. So the pharma companies have been very active. Every day new drugs are getting approved, but the diagnostics guys are lagging behind.
Yeah.
So that is the gap that we are filling in. So this whole pipeline of diagnostics are called companion diagnostics. So our whole mission is to find the right drug for the right patient.
Wow.
So this comes under that personalized medicine. So previously it was like one size fits all, everybody gets the same regimen, same treatment. But now we have to customize it based on the individual patient's genotype and phenotype. So since we use the computer vision technology, so we are calling it as Onco Phenomics.
Onco Phenomics.
Yes. And the downstream also, we also do the genomics work, so we look for the mutations. One interesting thing we have done is we are looking at how the immune system is attacking the cancer. So this is the latest trend in oncology called immuno-oncology. If you know the recent Nobel Prize winner, James Allison, so he's from MD Anderson. So I am part of that big group of immuno-oncology research scientists. Really proud to be associated with
them. We are very proud.
So they have started one institute called Park Institute of Immunotherapy and also Immuno Research. So we are associated with MD Anderson. So we are currently incubated in CCMD. So we have a world-class genomics laboratory up and running now. So we can do the tests right now, but we still have to go through the clinical trials
get
the approvals. But if any cancer patient wants to see how this liquid biopsy can help them, they can just contact us. We will supply the kits, the blood sample collection kits. Any phlebotomist can or a nurse can collect the blood sample. They can send it to us and we will do the testing for free.
You know, but I also want to ask is that is there a diagnostic test to just figure out that you might have symptoms of cancer or something?
So there are three major groups of diagnosis. There's a screening test. So right now we have a screening test for cervical cancer. Women who go for pap smear, which is made mandatory nowadays, and also the mammogram. So if there is some suspicion that they might be precancerous lesions, then we can do a testing. That comes with a screening test. Then we have a proper diagnostic test. We have a questionnaire which the patients have to fill. So here we look for inherited mutations, some family history of cancer. This is mainly for hereditary breast or ovarian cancer. Breast cancer is very easy to diagnose, but ovarian cancer, since it's inside the body, until it grows to a certain size, we don't know.
Yeah.
So we have early detection for ovarian cancer using the liquid biopsy. So when the tumor grows, it releases the DNA in the plasma. From the plasma, we isolate the cell-free DNA. So this is to detect the ovarian cancer-specific biomarkers in the cell-free DNA. So that one we have developed. And the third one is for lung cancer, which is one of the more common. Then prostate cancer is very easy. I don't even need a blood sample, just a urine sample is enough.
So, you know, I want to ask you, Shri, how did you get into this? Like, what made you start up?
So, I'm MBBS doctor. So, I did my research in ICMR, in TB, and HIV. I worked with Dr. Sonia Swaminathan. She's the current director for ICMR also. She's a WHO representative. This was way back in 2003. So then, motivated by the science, I went to US for my PhD. I continued in the infectious disease area. After graduating PhD, I was like, there are two roads. One road going into infectious disease, another road going into oncology. But immunology in cancer was very attractive. Just like how the body fights your bacteria and virus, it also fights the cancer.
Wow.
So the best treatment is make your immune system fight the cancer.
Wow.
So that is going to be the future in oncology. So my whole research experience has been in immuno-oncology.
Wow. Wow.
So I did my postdoctoral fellowship at MD Anderson, which is a very premier institute. For 4 years I was part of MD Anderson. So I was part of the Cancer Genome Atlas, just like the Human Genome Project. This was a very big project. More than 10,000 patients' data is available. So all we have to do is sequence the DNA of our patients, compare it with the database. Then we can also do the predictive test, prognostic test. This is the story today. What is going to be 6 months from now or 1 year from now? How the prognosis of the patient is going to be? Is it going to be an aggressive tumor? Is the cancer ever coming back? If you see today, you see a lot of even Bollywood celebrities. They're all cancer survivors, right? They had the treatment, they completed the chemo, they had the surgery, now they're perfectly all right. But every day they're living with the fear of when is the cancer coming back? Because it's definitely coming back. It's just a question of when, right? So it's like a 6 weeks or 6 months or 6 years. That's where we are positioning this companion diagnostics and liquid biopsy for a cancer surveillance. So it's not only as a screening test, but also as a surveillance. So these are the two big markets, the newly diagnosed patients and the cancer recurrent or metastatic patients.
Did you raise money?
Yeah, so last year we raised a seed round with Mumbai Angels for $500,000. So now we are going
for the
increases.
Everyone in the country should give you money. What you're doing is so impactful.
So we are also working with Let's Venture, so they are giving us a lot of commercial connects. But the whole reason I am in Bangalore is to network.
Where are you based?
So we are in Hyderabad.
No, we'll also make some introductions. Very honored, very humbled to meet you. What you're doing is extremely important for all of us in this country and the world. Please keep watching what he's doing and let's participate and see how we can join what he's doing and support. Should be any last message for everyone?
Yeah, so open invitation for any cancer patients or families or friends, whoever wants to get the liquid biopsies or companion diagnostics done. Right now it's in research phase, so now they can take the opportunity. There's no charge. Even we supply the kits, they just have to give us the consent form and send us the blood samples.
Great. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot. Thank you.